just a sign of like toilet. What's so important about is that we have to talk about.
Oh, come on, this is the sign of a new concept that is widely discussed all around the world these days. It's the sign of a unisex restaurant.
Yes, it has been a popular issue for a pretty long time already. Not to mention that we have one right here.
Here, Shizo, we built something like this in our school.
I know, right?
Okay, so I now know the name of the restroom, this kind of restrooms. But what's so special about it? Can it do anything else besides letting you pee in it?
Not exactly. Let's tell you more about this kind of toilet.
Okay, let's start to... this is the origin of the unisex restroom. There are some transgender people in Thailand who feel disturbed when entering the restroom because they don't know which restroom they should enter.
So does the government build it just for them?
Not really. Some parents think taking their children to a certain restroom is inconvenient because their senses may be different from their children's. For example, if a mom accompanies her kid to a men's restroom, it may be awkward enough. On account of these two reasons, some government officials came up with the idea of building unisex restrooms.
If someday I have to take my son to a men's restroom, oh, it will never happen. By the way, is there only one type of
No, not exactly. The unisex restrooms are not all identical. There are three kinds of unisex restrooms. One is that the urinals and toilets are in the same room.
Isn't it just the same as the restroom for the disabled?
Basically, they are the same, but there is one difference. There aren't safety rails in unisex restrooms.
Oh, I see.
Another is that urinals and toilets are separated in different rooms. But they are just next to each other. The other is that urinals and toilets are separated in different areas.
What's the difference among them? The third one is really similar to the second one.
Right, but the biggest difference between these two types of unisex restroom is the urinals in type C are built without doors, but type B are. And this is the plan about the unisex restroom in type C.
Can you tell me more about the unisex restroom in different countries? I want to know different kinds of unisex restrooms around the world.
Okay, first, let me introduce the unisex restrooms in Sweden. Most public restrooms are replaced with unisex restrooms. When walking on the streets in Sweden, you can see many unisex restrooms.
The second country is England.
Wow, there are about 64% of young people, English young people aged 18 to 24 year olds, feeling at ease when using unisex restrooms.
Yes, so a number of unisex restrooms are set in college in England.
Third, the unisex restroom in France.
It is really different from England.
Yes, there are about 57% of French 5 years old. And they feel comfortable when using unisex restrooms. So our country, the elders tend to support the construction of unisex restrooms.
Finally, the unisex restroom in America. The young people in America can feel at ease when using unisex restroom, just like the youth in England.
How about the unisex restrooms in Taiwan?
As you can see, unisex restrooms in Taiwan are not as prevalent as in all countries above. In Taiwan, there are more unisex restrooms in North than in France. For example, there are unisex restrooms in Taipa, and Shida, and Xizhou.
Although the government has made some plans about the unisex restroom construction in school and government institution, it is not common to see unisex restrooms in Taiwan.
I hope the government can be more devoted to setting more unisex restrooms in Taiwan, so that parents with children will not be disturbed and people with another psychological sex will not be judged. Thank you, Mother.